Hi, my name is Jackson. Today I want to show you how to listen to anything on your Mac computer for free. At the end of this video, you'll be able to turn this into this.
We are all fools in love.
Growing up, reading was a real pain for me. I remember trying to read and being bored out of my mind because it took so long. And as it turns out, I actually have a reading disability. But instead of spending hours trying to read a single page, I realized that I could listen to everything. Today, I do all my work using text-to-speech. Text-to-speech is a type of software that lets my computer take any text, whether it's a book or an article, and generate an audio version. There are lots of people out there who use this kind of software to read. Some people, like me, have a reading disability, like dyslexia, but others simply found out that they are just better off listening. For example, if you listen to everything, you can read books while you're taking a jog or while you're cooking. So let's jump right in. Alright, so I'll be doing this on my MacBook, but I'll post a video of how to do this later on a Windows computer or something very similar. So to start, open up your system preferences. You can do this by clicking the gearbox in the toolbar, or you can hit Command plus space and type in system preferences. Then click accessibility, or you can type in accessibility in the search bar and hit enter. Okay, so now we have these different options and we're going to navigate to the box marked speech. So it'll be under vision. And now we have this little box over here. We're going to actually change the system voice. And the reason we're going to do this is because the current system voice is called Alex. Now, Alex is an old Mac voice that they used to use a while back, but it's kind of outdated by now, and it's not that great sounding. So we're going to change the system voice by clicking on the box marked Alex, and we're going to hit customize. Now, there are a lot of varieties of voices, and there are different languages, but the one we're going to use for now is called Ava. So check the box next to Ava, and make sure that upgraded to enhanced quality is also checked, and then hit OK. It'll take a little bit to download, so I'm just going to skip ahead until it's finished. Now, during the download, you may have had some box that pops up that said something like, the voice is unavailable to download right now, and that's perfectly fine. It might mean that you're just not on great Wi-Fi connections, so try it again a few times and maybe move around. But if it doesn't work for a while, then message me or leave a comment in the video and I'll try to figure out what's going on. But your voice should be installed, so we're going to click on Alex again, and we're going to click on Ava to make sure that she is checked. Now we have to test our voice, so click the play button and listen to the new voice.
Hello, my name is Ava. I am an American English voice.
Now that sounds really good to me. I think it's a quite accurate voice. And so now we just need to make sure that this box right here, speak selected text when key is pressed, is checked. And if it's not checked, then make sure that it is. Once that's done, this basically sets up your computer so that it can read any text anywhere, anytime. Now I have an article already open that I'm going to just use as a little test from the New York Times. And what we're going to do is we're going to highlight this section and we're going to read what we want. So you select the text, and then you can either right-click and hit Services or Speech, sorry, Start Speaking, or you can hit your shortcut key, which is Option Escape.
Washington, a return of Kurdish commanders has revived a stalled American-backed ground offensive to wipe out the last pockets of Islamic State militants in eastern Syria.
So I pause it there because I want to explain a few things that are going on here. First of all, if you want to pause it or stop it, you just hit the same shortcut key again. And if you want to restart, let's say you don't want to start from the beginning again, you just select over here and you hit play again.
But the campaign may have...
There are a few things that I want to show you. The first thing I want to show you is that you can actually change the way that the computer speaks. First, you can adjust the speaking rate so you can make it a lot slower.
Hello. My name is Ava.
Or you can increase it so it sounds a lot faster.
Hello, my name is Ava. I am an American English voice.
That may have sounded like complete gibberish to you, and a lot of people think that that does. A lot of people are intimidated by how fast it sounds initially, but once they try, they actually get way past the point where it's the fastest, and we'll talk about that later. I'm actually at 700 words per minute, which is about over here. If there was a slider, it would be about twice as fast. I actually recommend that you start a little bit faster than normal because it makes the voice just a little bit smoother. The computer tends to speak very, very slowly. And just move it up maybe once a week just a little bit. Now, it's not for everyone, but I highly recommend and challenge you to try this and see how fast you can go. So what do you use text-to-speech for? School? Work? Leave a comment below and let us know. Or if you have any questions, also leave a comment. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you can have more content. We hope to hear from you soon.